temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No current feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No occurrent feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, What Spinoza said of regret. That whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that, the utility of negative sentiments. Emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee, of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments, as love and respect. No current feelings of love and respect, need to be present throughout the period, in which it is true that, one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief, offer a kind of testimonial, to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting, in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all, for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret. That whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that, the utility of negative sentiments. Emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without. Lies in their providing a kind of guarantee, of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments, as love and respect. No occurrent feelings of love and respect, need to be present throughout the period, in which it is true that, one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief, offer a kind of testimonial, to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting, in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all, for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret. That whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that, the utility of negative sentiments. Emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without. Lies in their providing a kind of guarantee, of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments, as love and respect. No occurrent feelings of love and respect, need to be present throughout the period, in which it is true that, one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief, offer a kind of testimonial, to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting, in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, Most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No occurrent feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No occurrent feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive occurrent feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No current feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive current feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No current feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive current feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect. Temporal resolution is particularly interesting in the context of satellite remote sensing. The temporal density of remotely sensed imagery is large, impressive, and growing. Satellites are collecting a great deal of imagery, as you read this sentence. However, most applications in geography and environmental studies do not require extremely fine-grained temporal resolution. Meteorologists may require visible, infrared, and radar information at sub-hourly temporal resolution. Urban planners might require imagery at monthly or annual resolution. And transportation planners may not need any time series information at all for some applications. Again, the temporal resolution of imagery used should meet the requirements of your inquiry. Sometimes, researchers have to search archives of aerial photographs to get information from that past that predate the collection of satellite imagery. Grief is unpleasant. Would one not then be better off without it altogether? Why accept it even when the loss is real? Perhaps we should say of it, what Spinoza said of regret, that whoever feels it is twice unhappy or twice helpless. Lawrence Thomas has suggested that the utility of negative sentiments, emotions like grief, guilt, resentment, and anger, which there is seemingly a reason to believe we might be better off without, lies in their providing a kind of guarantee of authenticity for such dispositional sentiments as love and respect. No current feelings of love and respect need to be present throughout the period in which it is true that one loves or respects. One might therefore sometimes suspect, in the absence of the positive current feelings, that one no longer loves. At such times, negative emotions like grief offer a kind of testimonial to the authenticity of love or respect.